call to order the Springboro Community City Schools Board of Education meeting for September 20th, 2016. Roll call.
Anderson.
Here.
Bath.
Here.
Belanger.
Here.
Blunt. Stuckey.
Here. Stand for the pledge, please.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
1.3, approval of the August 30th, 2016, meeting minutes. Have the motion?
1.2 says new agenda item.
Not a line.
So we're going to start with 1.3.
I'm using my press. Okay, here. 1.3, which is on her, not mine, adoption of the agenda, correct?
Yes.
Roll call. Or do I have a motion?
Second.
We threw you off, sorry, Dave.
It doesn't take much.
Anderson.
Yes.
Bath.
Yes.
Belanger.
Yes.
Stuckey.
Yes.
Blunt.
Yes.
1.4, approval of the August 30th, 2016, meeting minutes. Have the motion?
So moved.
Second. Roll call.
Anderson.
Yes.
Bath.
Yes.
Belanger.
Yes.
Blunt.
Yes.
Stuckey.
Yes. Public participation and introduction of guests, student success in action, Springboro Intermediate. Mr. Schreier.
Thank you, Mr. President, members of the Board of Education. It's my privilege tonight to welcome a group of 5 students who are with us from the seventh grade and the sixth grade here in the district. Their principal, Diane Stacy, is with us tonight, and she's going to introduce. I do want to make mention of all the parents and brothers and sisters that are here tonight, and we really appreciate you being here to support these great students. Well, I was just telling them, we have 1,000 sixth graders and seventh graders together, and you were the 5 picked tonight. That's pretty cool. So with that, Mrs. Stacy, if you'd introduce our program.
Okay. Good evening, Mr. President, members of the board, and thank you again from me to all the parents that have taken time out of busy schedules. I know the time of year it's very busy to bring your students out to join us. Last year, a program was instituted in Springboro Intermediate called vocabulary.com. And I'm very proud of this banner, even though I was not at Springboro Intermediate last year. We were the state champions for the program vocab.com. So I'm sure if you hear that word in the community, you're going to know how to react to it now, and you're going to know what it's all about, because our wonderful teachers and our wonderful students are going to explain a little bit to you how vocab.com works every day in the classroom. I have here with me, I have Mrs. Hecht, Mrs. Lori Hecht, who will be presenting. I also have Mrs. Sarah Guenther. Lindsay Guenther, I'm sorry, I called you Sarah. And I have Mrs. Sarah Young, who will also be presenting along with our students. I have AJ. I have, oh my goodness, they're going to put me to the test. One of them's Pam, and one of them is Andrea.
Pam's a second. To your left.
Pamela, Andrea?
Pamela's left.
Pamela, Andrea, okay, I got it. And I have identical twin grandsons too, so I get it. I also have Cassie, and then I also have Sam. So take it away, guys. Let's hear about this wonderful program. Okay. Okay, is it coming up?
Leslie Rose, technology.
I promise it was ready to go.
I promise.
I saw it.
I'll go to teaching. Go on, fly.
I And this is Google Classroom hard work, as you can see. There we go. Hey.
There we go.
So now that we're finally ready to talk about Captain Tom. This was a tool that was introduced to us last year. It was one of invaluable importance, I think. It's so quick and so easy to use, and really, it teaches them such a variety of skills. So these are our just a couple points about what it is, and we'll talk to you about why we use it. We'll have the kids talk to you as well about what they like about it. So vocabulary.com is first and foremost interactive, and it's rewarding, which is nice because that gives them a motivation to want to continue to learn these words. It considers a student as mastering a word if they can define it, they can use it and identify it correctly in multiple contexts, which is fantastic. And it also asks them to spell it, and it even taps into visual learners because it will give them picture questions as well, which of the following pictures demonstrates this word in action. Teachers can choose from hundreds of lists that are already created. My poor students are currently working on 100 words. Every middle schooler should know, because that's exciting, but necessary. But we can also create our own lists as well, which is awesome because it's really flexible for us. Students create their own lists as well to study from, so they can use this as kind of a self-driven study tool. And any and all teachers can create lists in this program. It doesn't have to be just language arts-based words.
And when Sam gets on here in a little bit, he's going to show you those three different options that we have.
So the question might come up as to why we are using vocabulary.com. Again, we started it last year around January and used it throughout the year, and the students were, first of all, very excited once we got into it and they understood it. But the reason we originally started it was because we knew that vocabulary was a weak area for our students. We knew that based on their test scores from the years prior. We also knew that from our observations in class. When they would get to a word they didn't know, they didn't know how to figure it out, break it down. And there was just a lot of words that seemed to be an issue for them. So we were trying to find a fun way to have the students work on vocabulary without, here's a list of words, study it, quiz on Friday, here's a list of words. So it was more interactive and more fun for the kids. It helps the students master the words. They're not memorizing the words, which I think back to when I was in school, in Springboro, not too long, a long time ago.
Yes, it was.
Mr. Stucky. I'm having my 25th reunion this weekend. Anyway, so they master the word. They know the word, they know what it means. Again, like Mrs. Ginther said, they can use it in multiple contexts. So it's not just one way that word can be used. And I really think that was an eye-opener for a lot of our kids. They'd see a word and be like, I know what that word is, but that doesn't make sense there. And then we talked about the multiple meanings of the word. It's competitive, which the students really like. Some of mine from last year were extremely competitive, especially maybe if they were related in some way. It became very competitive in the classroom. The students can see their scores, and it's competitive in two ways. They get points no matter what. Even if they're going through the words and they get them wrong, they get points. They get how many words they master. So they not only see their points, they also see words mastered, and they see themselves compared to other students in their class, other students in the building, and we'll get into on the next slide, other schools in the state of Ohio, as well as schools across the country, which they really like that. We were in the top five, or we were the top one of the day. It's user-friendly to teachers and students. Students very quickly, of course, they got on, no problem, because they're used to that. We got on there, we could access lots of lists, as Ms. Ginther said. We can make our own list, students can make their own list. It can be used in a variety of ways. If we're reading something in class, we can just use those words and put them in there. Also, as a teacher, I can monitor the students' progress. I can see how they're doing, how long they've been studying, how they're doing on words. I also can pull up on a list which words are giving them the most trouble. Which words are they all mastering? So I can pull groups of students who are struggling with one word, or I can say, okay, everybody, we're having a problem with the word, let's talk about it. If it's a word they're all getting, then we can move on.
from that word. So it's really good for us to progress monitor the students as well, and they can monitor themselves. So Mrs. Hex can talk about our standings, if you will.
Okay. The wonderful banner we were presented with a couple weeks ago stems from this information that I have here on the screen. We were Ohio State champions from January to May 2016. We started in January last year. So our students, we kind of took it over, which was really exciting. And at one point, we got a conference call from New York from the people who developed the program congratulating us on how well the students were doing, which was awesome. The kids got a real kick out of that, talking to somebody who had created the program. North America top 10 in February 2016, that was all across North America. We were in the top 10 that month. And the 2016-17 vocabulary goal starts October 1st, and the kids are raring to go on that. Sam is, yes. Sam asks me every day, where do I stand? Who's in first? Who has the most points? How many words have we mastered? Right now, we have students that are sitting in my classrooms with 80-some words mastered already on this program. Just going great guns with it. Today's leaderboard, SI, was fifth in the nation. So, great. We'd like to have Sam come up and get signed in. I want you to see what program.
Another really cool thing last year, towards the end of the year, the people came to our building from vocabulary.com. He was there last week too to present the banner. But he also came in and talked to some of the teachers who were on their plan, but he also came into the classroom and talked to the students and said, what would you like to see? What do you like about the program? What don't you like about the program? So I thought it was really neat that he, you know, was taking the students' viewpoint and also came to our building specifically and talked to the students. So,
what we do in vocab.com is we do words and stuff, and what I like is that we actually do it in some other classes, such as science over here. You can like listen to the word
environmentalist.
Going in those, and you can master them don't have them already mastered. Those are the troubled words that you have in your troubled section. So, thank you.
Thank you, Sam.
So I know we have other students here as well. I know we have three of at least, are you interested?
She's
a
nurse.
Yeah, okay. I don't want to say things out of turn. I know we have three of the five, top five from last year that were awarded from vocabulary.com last week. I don't know if any of them, or if you would like to chime in and tell everybody how many words about you've mastered or what you liked about it or anything like that. Come on. I don't have the list of the top five. Karen has that list. Ready for the challenge.
Yes.
When they came in to present the banner, they were like, we can do that easy. We're already at this point. So it's already become a big challenge for our students. Would you agree? Are you wanting to beat what they had?
Yeah.
So the top five were Pamela and Andrea, AJ here, and then Cameron Arndt and Colton Felipe. I hope I'm saying that right.
Philippine.
Okay. Yeah, there it is.
They couldn't be here.
They couldn't be here tonight. Those were the top five from last year.
Congratulations.
Yes, and as just in closing remarks, we all know that vocabulary, there's so much research around students and their knowledge of words and how successful that makes them as they go on through school because they can master content that they may not have known before by figuring out all those vocabulary words. So thank you everyone for listening. So proud of these five students and the rest of our building. Is continuing to work on vocab.com. So, thank you.
Students, come up here first. I want you to stand right here. I want you to face the board. Okay. Put your hand. You look good at that shirt, I gotta tell you. Stand side by side, face the board. All right, now, what questions do you have for these folks?
I have a question. Is this something you guys do just in the classroom, or do you take time at home to do it? You guys have a lot of words. That's not what my children choose to do at home.
Really?
So is there like time, like where your teacher's doing, working with a small group of kids, doing something different, and then there's like, you have time that you can get out your computers and do vocabulary.com, and then you can also log in at home? Is that how it is? Okay, awesome. That's incredible. Great job.
Other questions? All right, guys, we're going to get your picture with the board in just a little bit, but let me tell you, I said I had a surprise for you. We called the librarian today and asked the librarian what were some of the more popular books that you guys are reading nowadays. I've never heard of anything like this. I mean, these things got dragons on it, ships, but these are some good books. Here's what we have tonight. We do this with our board meetings. Inside each book is a label. And this label said this book is donated to the Springboro Intermediate Library on behalf of Sam. Which one's Sam? There's Sam. For his presentation at the Springboro Schools Board of Ed meeting on September 20th. So, Sam, whenever someone goes in the library and they check this book out, they're going to see your name and you're going to sign this in a little bit, that this book is there because you made a presentation. How cool is that? And each one of you, I've got here for you a book that you're going to sign. You guys get to sign one together. You got two labels inside. So I'm going to put these on the table. I'm going to have you sign. But before we do, let's get a picture with the Board of Education. Step one around. And teachers, if you want to join.
Kids are
going to
be right in front of the board that I'm touching.
I'm not seeing right now.
You said it was cool. You're supposed to say.
Yes, kids are all done.
Done, you got to keep up there for your parents. They're taking pictures.
Double for you guys.
Okay, hold on. Parent time. You guys look good.
Yep, I do.
Yeah. All good on pictures? How about a round of applause for them again? All right, guys. Mrs. Stacy's got the books for you. Mr. President, that ends our. Oh, and parents and students. We love for you to step. It really gets exciting. It really does. It gets pretty boring from here on out. So if you want to stay great, this is a great time for you to head on out. Thanks for being here. Mr. President, that ends our Success in Action. The students obviously are going to sign the books. Mrs. Stacy will take them to the library tomorrow. And we are ready to move on. Mrs. Stacy, how do we get that? Is it a subscription? Yearly? How much is it? You know?
I believe it's $1,600.
So a student has to get on there.
Education Association for report. 2.3 Springboro Classified. I don't think there was any participation prearranged. Any of you guys want to talk public participation now? No, good. All right, convene for a work session. For the camera. If there were people from the audience or from the community here, they could ask questions after each one of the items.
We have one here. She's tucked away.
I'm sorry. I apologize. If you have a question on any of these work session items, you may ask after we're done with each one. So the first one, committee reports.
Thank you, Mr. President. What you're being handed is what you were emailed earlier last week. In meeting with all the administrators, as far as building principals, central office team, we looked at the current district committees, and we are proposing some changes. It doesn't need to be board approved or any kind of motion. As long as you're okay with it, we'll move forward. On the front page are the district committees. These are the committees that have a board member or board members a part, that we have community representatives on this. So that you're aware again, we removed two of the committees that were on previously, Public Relations and Communications Team and the Community Service Advisory Team. Both of those were recommended to be removed thanks to the administrators that work with them and the lack of work that is going to happen this year because that work has happened in the past. The Compensation Evaluation Committee you will not see there because that is going to be combined with the Financial Insurance Team. So on the top right, Financial Insurance is now Compensation and Evaluation. Now, all of these committees, we currently have board members on. Typically, board members would change, would go to a different committee in January for organizational meeting. Very thrilled if someone wants to add their name, but we can also do that in January meeting. We will be promoting this or putting this out on Facebook, website. Karen has a way to put this out there so the community sees. Here's the committees, here's the reps, here's the meeting times if someone would like to attend. The other side real quick before we talk about the front, those are the internal meetings from central office to principal to our district leadership team and so forth. Those typically do not have board members on those. Those are more of the administrators or teachers who represent buildings or the nurse or so forth in those groups. With that being said, questions, comments?
I like how last year we had, and we had discussed this like in January, February, the front side was considered superintendent committees, but they really weren't. So we discussed at the new school year having treasurer committees and superintendent committees. I think this overall umbrella of district committees is a good overall umbrella. I was talking with Tara about it today, because really the way that you've got facilitators, it's a wide variety of facilitators. So I think that that's a good umbrella description because it gives flexibility as to who the facilitator is. So I like the way that that is put. So for the parent involvement, the community reps, will that, if there's going to be different people, are you proposing that happens in January?
Typically that would, but when you look at that, for example, where's the one? Policy committee, right now we only have one. And so we'll talk about the communication with that, but we may reach out or have someone volunteer to be a second one for that. If someone would like to be a part of it, they can certainly let us know. And in January, obviously it'll come again. Parents or community members can come to any of them. I believe how they kind of sit in the back as the meetings happen and they're able to ask questions and so forth and listen.
I think that all of these parents that are on here are fabulous, very, very involved parents. So it's nothing, they're all fabulous assets to our community. I think that we should make sure that we're opening it up so that the people that are the actual committee members, we make sure that we don't keep the same parents in that position every year, because typically in the past we've gone school year to school year, because like with district parent council, it says to be determined, because I think that's going building by building. So this budget and finance isn't necessarily a building to building, but if you have somebody who has a senior, it kind of makes more sense to do it school year to school year, because if you have a senior, you're not going to pick, you're not going to join something in January if a senior is leaving in May. Does that make sense?
I think that's a great suggestion, and I think we can put that out when we broadcast this out, that we're open for people to see if they'd like to be part of it. Yeah.
Right. That's my only suggestion. Like, it's nothing. These parents that are on here and community members are fabulous, fabulous. I just don't want to disclude anybody that would want to be on there. But I think all the committees are great.
And I'm thrilled with the fact that Ashley did a lot of work in getting these dates set up now so that they're locked in, so people can put in their calendars and we do not plan to change those. Mr. President, that's all the notes I had, unless there's other questions. Okay.
3.3 OSBA Southwest Region Fall Conference, October 13th.
I have a handout that was also emailed to you folks. It's just the agenda for the fall conference. It's Thursday, October 13th, in the Southwest region. When it comes time for the Ohio School Boards Association, I've been part of this one. I've been a part of Northwest. It's well known around Ohio, Southwest region. It's the biggest one. They're very active. And they do a nice job with awards, presentations, and so forth. Being a sports fan I am and a Reds fan, it was great to see that they're going to be awarding the Friend of Education Hall of Fame Award to Hal McCoy, Cincinnati Reds beat writer. Boy, I'm hoping that they put him behind the microphone and just let him talk for a couple hours. Can you imagine the storage of the Red Machine? The reason we bring that to you, A, is awareness. B, that is our next board meeting. If we want to go to this, either as an entire board team, treasurer, superintendent, we would need to move our board meeting and look at the calendar to maybe Tuesday, October 11th. And then we would need to either let me know tonight or Ashley next day or two if you go, we've got to get the reservations. So obviously you don't need a board motion to move the board meeting date. It's just if October 11th works, enough of you want to go to this event, we can make the change.
Have you been to these in the past? What is typically, is it anything where they're educating us on stuff, or is it just a lot of awards to people?
It is a lot of awards. There are updates. If you look at the 640, recognize, okay, OSBA update. There will be the president, the state president from OSBA, will speak usually 10, 15 minutes. And then Rick Lewis runs the Ohio School Board Association Ohio. He will speak about 30, 35 minutes about education updates. Some of it will be new, some of it will be received in emails. The rest of it is really a celebration. You will see other board members from all over Southwest Ohio, other administrators. It's a time to come together. We can have our own table. If we don't have enough people, there'll be another school sit with us. There will be some conversation too. But yeah, the education comes down to a couple of presentations, but it's mainly a celebration. We don't have any awards from Springboro. We will next year. And that's one thing I always enjoy doing is getting our programs, getting our teachers nominated for these kind of things. If you'll notice the very last thing, actually, I take that back. Look at the bottom right. I thought that would be the 15th. It says recognition of the 2016 Capital Conference Southwest Region Student Achievement Fair participants. We will be there. Mr. President, I didn't realize, I didn't see that until now. We have two groups have been selected, as you saw, the Student Achievement Fair. Two high school students, two high school teams. They will be invited this night. They will be honored. They'll be able to sit and have a meal and get recognized in front of everyone. So, Mr. President, thank you for seeing that right now. I think it'd be great for us to be there.
We need to change the date.
Can we go October 11th? Is Tuesday, October 11th work for a board meeting? Does anyone have any issues with that on the calendar? All right, and then if you would, just either text me, email, Ashley tomorrow, does that work? Jenkins. All right, good.
3.4 NSBA conference, March 25th to 27th.
We do not have a handout today. I sent you a link to that. The link kind of shows some of the overview of the conference. It's my understanding that this board or members of this board went to Boston last year for the NSBA. I only bring it up because when last year, and Mrs. Babbitt said it might be a good thing to discuss tonight on whether or not we want to send one, two, three, four members to the event. Open up for discussion.
I guess my thought with that, this is just, I'm not talking to anybody about it. My thought with this is we have a lot going on next year. I personally think we would serve ourselves better to do a retreat locally that we're really focusing in on our local needs and what we could be doing as a board, just really, if we do anything, bringing in somebody local to help us dealing with our individual Springboro needs. So personally, I think it was great to go to it. I learned an absolute ton. But I think for this year, my vote would be to stay local and to definitely have a retreat, a weekend retreat that is a full weekend, that is a focus, but it's focused on Springboro and what do we need for this next year and working together as a board. So that would be my recommendation.
I don't have a problem with that as well as if somebody wants to do this too. You can do both, can't
you? Oh, you could do both, yes. It doesn't have to be all five board members.
No, I think, what, three of us went last year?
Yeah, it was good. I mean, I think personally, I probably took a little bit more out of the Capitol conference. And the one I thought, just at least when it dealt with maybe some things a little closer to home. There were a lot of positives though from the conference in Boston as well, but I think it's one that I was necessary to attend to full board every year. There's one sort of small or something, but I think the Capitol conference, for me, some of the stuff is a little more applicable.
This one's March 25th. So. Probably be 10 feet of snow.
It's a Saturday, Sunday.
You may get lucky if you stop there for a week.
We got time to decide.
Well, we do. And the thing is, in first time dealing with this board, typically not a board, is it a board motion to put to this? Or board members just want to go?
Yeah, we put it on for a work session item for the last time.
Okay. Sounds good. All right.
2.5, discussion of other business.
I don't. Okay.
Treasurer's report. Go ahead, Carol. All right.
The first thing I have is the August financials. I was going to ask too, because typically when I went back all the way for several years, and it's the way I've done it since I've been here too, I've always brought them in the second meeting. That's how it's always been. And I kind of feel like we're almost into September now, and now we're just now approving August. So everything I talk about, I have more information, but I don't really talk about the more information because we're only approving information for August. So if it would be better, I can try to start, as long as the meeting isn't too early in the month, I can have the financials done at the first meeting of the month versus the second. So we'll at least be fresh off of that month closing. So, you know, I feel like this is kind of old news for me anyway, but you guys might not have heard of it until the board agenda was posted. So just a suggestion, if that's something you guys would like me to do, I can start putting the financials on at the beginning of the month or the previous month.
Yeah,
probably a little more relevant at that time. August wasn't a super busy month in terms of a lot of changes being made. A lot of things are still being ordered, so the expenses still are going to be coming through in later months. So actually, when I compare revenue from last year this time versus this year this time, we actually have $200,000 more in revenue that we received this year than we did this time last year. So we're up on revenue by $200,000. As far as expenditures, going through the expenditures for last month, there wasn't a lot of oddities. We had $155,000 we spent on paving, Clear Creek, some Five Points, a little bit at the high school. So that was the largest abnormality of what usually occurs in a month to month. And as far as expenditures, we're actually down just under $100,000 from this time last year. So we're actually up on revenue and down on expenses. So that's good. Our cash balance is $11,682,000 ending August, which is up about $100,000 from that time the year before. So
where did the increase in revenue? Is that just additional property tax for this year? Or?
Yes, we're going to start to feel that. It'll come through, half of this comes through now, and then the other half will come through next year, and we'll start getting the first half of the previous year taxes, which will start coming in around February. So we will notice after September, which we've already received our settlement in for Warren County in September now, so we won't see that reflected in August, obviously, but in September we receive that. So our revenue will actually dwindle quite quickly between next month and February, around the beginning of mid-February, then we'll start receiving the tax advances from the second half, and we'll also see an increase then as well from the fact that our valuation increased and we got a little bit of money there. So other than that, the financials are pretty stable, everything is pretty on par, and you know, when you look at the monthly estimates that I provide, you know, sometimes they look out of whack, and I would say this, that it's because we're front end heavy, and it'll take several months for the capital needs and the supplies to kind of catch up, because
their own purchase at the beginning of the year for the most part, and then if those expenses will move along as we get back. Right now, nothing is out of whack, so I'm expecting a non-budget for those items. And I just received, within the last few days, updates from the different departments for me to kind of look at where they're at and additional needs that they need. And so far, I haven't received any requests for any additional funds. So everything looks like we're going to stay in budget. And then when we bring the five-year, we'll be looking at the CCP possibly, some tweaks there. But so that's the financial. So unless you have any questions, that's what those are pretty standard for right now. And my next item is the appropriations. And this is one which is something that I agree and we need to do, but I do want to say something about these appropriations. I was told earlier, I got a call from Lisa, and she had mentioned that Larry Budd had posted something that the district was about to approve $61 million in appropriations, as if it was some crazy oddity. That is all funds. So a lot of times when we talk and we go over the financials, I always hit on the five-year forecast, because that's pretty much what we're looking at is five-year forecast. But that's just general fund. There's a lot of other funds within the district. Grant funds, our bond retirement fund, our food service fund, all of our student activities and athletics. All of those funds together must be reported to the county each year. At the beginning of the year, and then usually I'll do a change, just to update and tweak around January, February, March, and then do a final at the end of the year. It's a requirement that we're required in order to be in compliance with the county and with the state. So last year, our expenditures total were just over $60 million. So for us to be doing an appropriation which was $61 million, that's normal inflation. I don't expect it to be $61 million. I do expect it to be less. But how it works is, if we do it for exactly what we believe we're going to spend, if the board chooses between now and any given month to approve something new that comes up, it can't be approved until I go to the auditor and we have appropriations re-approved, and then the board can act. So it's just, it's more for you kind of give yourself a little buffer if your cash will support it. So that you don't have to run into those timing issues of having to go back and forth to the county. Right. So this is...
In terms of the budgets that are pushed down through the buildings, they would sum up to this.
Right. Well, they sum up to it, but they're not all appropriated to the building levels. Some of them are contingencies that we hope... Yes. So as far as on budget, I don't expect to be anything over budget unless it's something that we come with the October forecast and we have some differences in the October forecast that the board will approve that. And then if the next time I go back to the county, then we will adjust the appropriations at that time if there was anything that we needed to do, which I don't anticipate this year needing to do that. So right now these appropriations are completely in line and it's normal. So just that scare of the $61 million, it was 60 last year. It's not that much different than last year. This one, you guys know that it wasn't some crazy new thing or something that happened. We also have donations. There's several donations, actually. Approval to accept a donation from Doug Webb to help purchase a freezer for the athletic training room at the Springboro High School. There's also another donation for various educational tools from Donors Choose, valued at $755.21 for Dennis second grade. And a donation of a power skater dry land training system from Bill Hazel, valued at $400 from the Springboro High School hockey program. That's it.
Okay. Any questions? I have a motion to accept items 4.1 through 4.5.
So moved.
Second.
Second.
Welcome.
Anderson?
Yes.
Chad?
Yes.
Belanger?
Yes.
Lund?
Yes.
Dickey?
Yes. Superintendent's report.
Mr. President, I only have one item tonight. We are asking for your approval of this fairly quickly here because of the timing. And let me explain. On March 13th, we have a planned teacher work day. It's part of the approved calendar last year. In meeting with the administrators, especially the principals, talk about professional development, and realizing doing professional development March 13th, okay, you've only got a couple months left in the year. With some of the professional development that we're doing, and Lee Benson's been doing a nice job working with the team discussing that, we believe if we can do that professional development on November 11th, we have a lot more time to implement and to become more proficient in that professional development. With that being said, November 11th is Veterans Day. Many government offices are already closed that day. And so the kids would stay home, staff would come in for that day. It's not a change in their hours, it's not a change in the day's work. We're just moving March 13th to November 11th. The kids will be in school March 13th. If it's something you would not do, I mean, you can die for lack of emotion or lack of a second. But we don't see any problems in the calendar, any scheduling conflicts. And again, our administrators think it's going to work with that.
So now we have two hesitations. Number one, all the teachers that have to come to work, their kids are going to be at home. So you have to kind of be careful of that.
That would happen March 13th, too.
Right, but they plan for it.
That's truly the right plan.
And then the March date, we have the 10th is a work day, which is a Friday. And then the 11th, 12th, and 13th would be off. So you have a long weekend then?
Oh. I think he was saying the wrong date. I think he actually
was it
meant
the
10th
that was being switched?
I'm sorry, it's supposed to be March 10th.
Okay, I was going to say, if you're talking that long of a weekend, you're going to upset right. A lot of folks. So.
March 10th was the teacher working day. That's a typo. My apologies, I missed that.
Okay, that makes more sense.
We are moving the March 10th teacher in service day to November 11th.
The 10th is a work day, the 13th is the in-service day.
Yeah.
So it is a four-day weekend.
Oh, so
it's a four-day weekend currently for families.
Correct.
For our teachers.
Correct.
Regardless.
So it is taking away a teacher.
We are moving the
13th. Away a four-day
correct.
Weekend,
the 13th is the correct day that's being moved. Because
okay.
The 10th is a teacher
so
work day.
This is what's currently
but it's giving us
so it's currently the 10th. You want to move it here?
It's creating a 3-day.
No, that's not what's currently approved. This is what's currently approved should be the 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th is a four-day weekend in March.
The current calendar that I'm sitting here looking at is, hold on here, current calendar, and I appreciate that. Right now, the calendar that you can open up on Board Docs, right, it says March 10th is a teacher work day. There is nothing listed on Monday, March 13th.
I think because this is the updated calendar.
That's the updated calendar. Right, the one that's, yeah.
Gotcha. Thank you.
You did put that up.
So, that's right. We okay, good. We from a 4-day weekend to a 3-day.
So, I mean, then you get 2 3-day weekends, yep. Which is, you know, that's
so
nice
again,
as well. But
we thought it would work for the teacher.
I just worry that people may have plans already. I don't know if they would or not, but.
Can I ask what the professional development, like what type of thing are you guys working on that, like is it a district, like is it a critical thing? Because I know that we're short on professional development because of how we started the school year early, and we've been concerned with that.
The September 30th will be selected professional development that are based on our goals that we created last year. So we have made a calendar both for those 2 days that used to be waiver days, and now we just call it in-service days. And we are following those up every month with, like we have this week is the we're putting 2 hours. We're taking the staff meeting and we're taking the early release. And so we're doing 2 hours a month that correlate with the big sessions. So we're doing small sessions and big sessions that are correlating with the mental health, the academic achievement, training on co-teaching, all of those things that are looking to improve student achievement and a report card, plus looking at educating the entire child, both social, emotionally, behaviorally, and academically.
The reason we want to move up the date from March to November is to be able to then put things in action for the school year.
That makes sense.
When you look at it, I guess I get that with the 4-day thing, but
it's more important.
It is. So, and those are such huge pieces, and when you look at it, that's all, you know, we've only got a couple of 2.5 months left at that point.
And we have 6 weeks of testing now. So we start mid-April and we go all the way through May. So we, by that time, we are solely looking at cleaning up the year,
absolutely,
getting those lost, you know, nuggets of learning, and really getting them prepared for testing.
We have a similar, situation with the 2017-2018 calendar we need to address sooner.
I can pull it up right now.
Mm-hmm. I don't have it in front of me.
Yeah. We might might.
I mean, Derek, but I share the concern about the changes late. I agree that it's the right thing.
It's the exact same scenario the second weekend in March in 2018.
Yeah, so I mean, I'd love to see us address that one.
Change it.
Yeah, at a future meeting, you know, well in advance or not. Because I think conceptually it makes all the sense in the world to have that development at the beginning, right? Not before everyone's about to go into testing.
I agree.
Is this something, and this is something, I know Jamie and I were in, I don't know what meeting we were in, but we were discussing this. With the number of hours that we're in school, I know that we're in school more than we have to be.
Yes.
Is there any way that we could give kids a day off and still stay within the perimeters of a teacher's contract and have them come to school for professional development to get another day of PD for them, but still stay within the perimeters of everything? I just feel like we're not doing what's best for teachers to get through all of that. We're expecting them to do all this stuff, but we're not giving them the training. Could we do that without totally?
We can, but again, you're taking, you know, 6.5-7 hours of instruction away from the children. A lot of times, you know, at the end of the year, you know, maybe there's not as much learning maybe taking place last week at school, you end school. But to take another day away at the start of the year from professional development, it's taking seat time away from the kids. Yeah, our amount of time the kids have to be here is more than the state says they have to. But we try not to take too many days away from the kids and take them away from the seat time. We're going to try to do as much professional development as we can with the 2-hour early releases through these 2 1-day things we do with September 30th and we do November 11th. And if we need more professional development, we look at that as a team and decide, you know, we need an extra 2 hours, we need an extra half a day, and we can adjust. We try to do as much as we can while keeping kids in school. Team, would I be appropriate with that?
It sounds like if there was, go through it and it's determined at a later point, there isn't an additional need.
We can come back to
add something like that.
Yes.
It's not open to, I guess it's assessing and seeing if there's a true need for it.
And any school district do that. It's happened to me a couple times in my career where all of a sudden something hit us. We really needed to train the staff, whether it was mental health, whether it was student safety. Maybe it was something with the state tests. And we thought, we're just not going to do it summer, we're going to do it now. And yeah, we let the kids, maybe they go home earlier, took a full day off. The state allows that now, the way the hours are. But also part of the reason the state did that with the hours was when you have those huge snow years, they don't have to add 3 days and 4 days, you know, to do the calamity day. This way it's up to the school district on how they do the calamity days. So, do we need a motion if we want to do that?
Is there a motion to change or?
Knowing that we will bring the 17-18 calendar back to the meeting soon.
Charlie, yep. So. Is there a second?
Second.
Yes.
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 Yes. Executive Director's report, please.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen of the board. This evening I bring forward approval of student services and private placement contracts. You will find that they were on board docs ahead of time and that we are looking to get those approved for students with special needs served under their IEPs.
Any questions? Is there a motion to accept? Second. Roll call.
Anderson?
Yes.
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 Yes. Executive Director of District Operations, John.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, for your consideration tonight, I have two items. Our normal personnel report that consists of several resignations, one termination, several supplemental approvals. This is rather lengthy due to the fact that this is our normal time that we take action on supplementals. And then the second item number two, is a recommendation for approval of an extension of our HVAC preventive maintenance contract with Peck Hanford and Briggs.
Any questions for John?
I just have a quick question. I know this is always the board meeting with all the subcommittees.
Yes.
Are those Is the amount that we pay for supplemental something that is negotiated with the unions and then based on their years of experience with the supplemental?
Correct. There's salary schedules that they go, and that's how we do the supplemental contract.
But they're not part of the bargaining?
It's not actually part of the bargaining unit contract, but it's still, we've got a framework for how we try to determine how those are and things. You know, a good example of that is the one that you approved last time or the time before for the DC trip supplemental.
Right.
So that, you know, we tried to do that in line with other supplementals that have about the same number of students, the same level of work that's required for those. So that's how those supplemental, so we actually have a supplemental contract that's actually tied to the salary schedule. So that's how those are determined.
So then how are some determined that some are paid for out of the 018 account?
That's a good question, because I don't, that's, those, the 018 accounts have been,
you know,
that's a
I
long time.
My very first time, very first month that I was here, and it was explained to me that due to some budget cuts, and there wasn't able to, the general fund wasn't able to pay for them all, so they basically said to the building, except we'll pay for one, the board will pay for one, and then you guys can fundraise and do other things through the 018 for the second one. And so this was split at that time. So
this is still, I remember when all that happened, because a lot of supplementals got cut. So this is still, that still remains true. So all those 018s are still covering those supplementals.
Yes, and they're still covering the supplementals. And then there's also sometimes
we have
supplementals are just not filled, but they're left, or
right,
in case at a future time they are to be filled and not eliminated. But there have been several,
correct,
in the last few years that were just not filled as well.
Correct.
Gotcha.
Okay. Right, we don't, this is not all the supplementals that we have.
Yeah,
these are just the ones that
are
we fill.
Part of the bargaining unit, except for athletics.
Correct.
Athletics is the only stuff that is not part of the bargaining unit.
Right.
Those are done outside of that. They're not tied to the salary schedule. Everything else is.
Correct.
Except for, like, extended days, that's the daily rate. But yeah, supplementals.
But they're not, but the interesting thing is the supplementals, if you look at the teacher contract, the supplementals are, not all of them are included in there.
There's some that, kind of, I think, yeah, some of them are like MOUs and things,
correct,
that are added separately, and then with the contract agreement, all added in together. So if there's some things that have been approved,
right,
at a different time, things will be added into the next contract, so we'll go off and we'll do until then.
Oh, I see.
So there's, but yeah, if you look at the back of the actual contract, they're all those different things are listed.
Right.
But if you're seeing two team leads in the CM, or let's say eighth grade trip, the reason that there's a difference in price is based off of the years of experience.
Well, some of it's years of experience, some of it's how many students, how much time it takes to do that supplemental,
gotcha,
how much direct contact you have with students. Those are all the things that come into play when you look at that.
Well, they were all part of the bargaining unit. So SBA gave it up.
Right.
Oh, really?
Yes. Coaches and people were very happy.
Yeah.
Yeah, the athletics was good. The athletics supplementals were good out of the bargaining units.
So who makes those decisions as to what we pay supplementals
they
for athletics?
They stay the same unless we come back and ask for an increase, which we did 2 years ago. We came back and asked for a 2% increase, I believe. And they have not been adjusted since then.
Right. Correct.
Okay, thanks.
We have a motion now. Okay, motion to accept 7-1, 7-2 and 3. Second.
Anderson?
Yes.
Bab?
Yes.
Warden?
Yes.
Yes. Board member reports and comments, questions. 8.1, approval of administrative salary increase, including superintendent and treasurer. Any discussion?
My only comment with this is when we started this discussion, you know, it actually started this summer. Because typically it's something that is brought to the board over the summer. And then with the transition in the superintendents, there's been a delay on it. And when I was thinking about making the decision, my thought was it was a time for us as a board to recognize what the administrators had done in the past. when I look at the report card, and I feel like, and I know all test scores have gone down a little bit with air testing, but I feel like Springboro has done a fabulous job. So my thought was, this was a time to look at the cost of living and to do what we can to help supplement that a little bit. So my intent, I'm going to vote yes for this because I absolutely support it. My intent was for it to be for the administrators that from the past, because I felt like we just brought some administrators on. So it's a little bit different than what I thought it would be, but I think when I look at our administrative team as a whole, and I this goes back to board comments, I'm amazed when I really was you know, the report card has all these different tabs, and I just feel like you keep on clicking on them, and it brings more and more information up, and it presents it in all kinds of different ways, and I'm amazed at what we've been able to do. And I, having sat through so many different meetings and knowing what you guys did with the data and seeing the different areas that were attacked and then seeing what it did in the report card and how we were able to raise scores, it's exciting to me. So good job, administrators, and I 100% support this. I think it's exciting, so thank you. That's all I have to say.
Good. Have a motion to accept the charter. Second.
Second.
Roll call.
Anderson?
Yes.
Jack?
Yes.
Lajay?
Yes.
Lund?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Comments and questions? Mr. Lund?
I don't have a lot to say tonight, but I did want to say thank you to the community. The boy that came down with cancer, such a sad, sad thing. I don't know him personally, but seeing the reaction of the community amongst the school system and all the support that they're giving this kid and his family, I commend it very highly. I just thought I'm amazed at the strength this community can do to build up people. It's great.
Mr. Walchek?
I don't have anything tonight, Mr. President.
I said what I had to say.
Charles. Just a couple things real quick. That was kind of what, following along with what Darren said, Thursday is what cancer awareness, isn't it? Kicking.
Cancer.
Yeah. Josh Depp is coming back. He did it last year, I believe, too, during this time to kick. And I guess based on how far he can do it is how much money has been donated. Is that correct?
He will do 4 field goals.
Okay.
And those donations, with a donation tied to each, we anticipate he'll make them all, and those donations go to the Breast Cancer Research Foundation. Okay. Then he will go to the other end of the field, and he'll do a kickoff. The first donations come from People's Bank. He goes to the other end and does a kickoff, and car insurance has pledged $20 per yard, and so they're anticipating $1,500, and that will be donated to the Michael Reese Fund.
Okay. And it, obviously for breast cancer, but with the situation with Mac Reese, it's kind of all falling together to kind of help and bring things together for that young man too. Should I say, is there, what about the guests? Maybe a surprise guest?
There may be multiple surprise guests.
Oh, multiple?
Yes. Of course, we're the Thursday Night Lights team, and we've been told we're the pickup as the national Thursday Night Lights team. So we have that going on. So we're going to have cameras on campus from, I think, 6:30 a.m. on Thursday all the way until we shut the lights off Thursday night. And so that's exciting. Our t-shirts were designed by a student, and we just keep ordering more and more t-shirts, and all of those proceeds go to Mac Reese's family as well.
All right, thanks. Then lastly, I wanted to thank you for jumping in head first with what you were presented with. You know, we came, you know, things happened so fast with Todd leaving and you coming on. Not everything got finished, but you know, you're doing a good job at continuing to deal with what's been happening. I've had nothing but positive comments from the community members. Chamber of Commerce people that I've talked to, assistant city manager and the manager there, I know you were going to talk at Heatherwood the other day, and you said, Kyle, we had a board meeting that night, but I know you've met the president of the homeowners over there. He feels, you know, very comfortable with what you're doing and so forth. Just wanted to say, you know, that I appreciate what you're doing, and you have my total trust and support to continue. All right, any announcements, future considerations? No? All right, 9.1. Need a motion to move into executive session to consider the appointment, employment, dismissal, discipline, promotion, demotion, or compensation of a public employee or official. Matters required to be kept confidential by federal law or regulations or state statute. There will be no action when we are finished with the executive session. Do you have a motion?
So moved.
And a second.